It's the nicest in fall in Bee Hill City. This is what Miss Maggie says whenever I run into her on the shore. She likes walking her old dog there. But now, as the afterglow is bending on the waves, I can feel something special and strange in the air. A little prickle. So I can't help saying yes and laughing, and of course scratching old Bobby. He likes it. Yes, it was a beautiful fall. As I'm wondering, looking at the sparkling water, I'm sure it's been the best year of my life. After that terrible disaster, which had swept over my life like a tornado, I've been fumbling my way in vain. Neither Japan nor Brazil and their picturesque countrysides could help me forget my mourning and grief. But now, at last, I'm home again, where I've always belonged. Now I feel happy again after so many years. I had arrived when the last traces of snow had just melted. I had all my mysterious fruit in a big case, achievements of my hard work in the last few years. My granny, Veronica, was waiting for me. The sun was dancing on her red Mercedes. It's never bothered her if she made a stir. I was going to enter the famous gardening competition in our city, the finest flowers, the next day. As it was the 100th anniversary of this competition, the first prize was worth much more than usual. I won't let the cat out of the bag if I tell you that I won the competition. I can tell you everything, everything about my last 6 months. It wasn't so easy sometimes. Anyway, what is the first prize? I'll tell you soon.
Uh-uh. Thank you.
Well, yes, my first round victory surprised my rivals. I can still remember how amazed John the Hunk and Sally the Bustling were when they saw my beautiful flowers. As a biologist, I was doing research on cross-fertilizing flowers. That's how I could make my crossbreeding machine, which was the key to my success. Granny Veronica praised me. My little girl, it's a pity your father couldn't stay with us any longer. He would have been proud of his daughter. Father taught history at the university, but it wasn't unusual that he would set off immediately when anyone came across an interesting archaeological find. He loved these expeditions. They were on their way to explore a recently discovered ancient Incan temple in northern Chile, when they got into a storm. We don't know exactly what happened there that night, but the weeks-long search for him was unsuccessful. Only the wreckage was found on the coast of Chile.